बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सॉलिड फेज सिंथेसिस ऑफ ओलिगोमेरिक मॉलिक्यूल्स। दीज आर द की कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल टॉक अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द सिंथेसिस ऑफ पेप्टाइड्स and why peptides are synthesized through solid phase synthesis, and after that we will discuss about the solid phase peptide synthesis and the protocols of this synthesis by using the FMOC strategy in peptide synthesis, after which we will discuss about the deprotection of FMOC and Bok strategy in peptide synthesis, in the last the isolation and purification of the peptide chains that are synthesized through solid phase organic synthesis. Introduction. Solid phase synthesis. What is solid phase synthesis? In the basic method of solid phase synthesis, building blocks that have two functional groups are used. One of the functional groups of the building block is usually protected by protecting group. The starting material or the substrate. The starting material is a bead which binds to the building block. At first, this bead is added into the solution of the protected building block and is stirred. After the reaction between the bead and the protected building block is completed, the solution is removed and the bead is washed. Actually, this is the step-by-step synthesis. Then the protecting group is removed and the above steps are repeated. After all the steps are finished, the synthesized compound is chemically cleaved from the bead. After this synthesis involves the protection of selectively one functional group, while for to react to the other functional group with the second monomer molecule. If a compound containing more than two kinds of building blocks is synthesized, a step is added before the deprotection of the building block bound to the bead. A functional group which is on the bead and did not react with an added building block has to be protected by another protecting group, which is not removed at the deprotective condition of the building block. Byproducts which lack the building block of this step only are prevented by this step. In addition, this step makes it easy to purify the synthesized compounds after cleavage from the bead. At the end of or at the completion of the this synthesis, the excess reagents are washed off. Solid phase synthesis is a common technique for peptide synthesis. Usually, peptides are synthesized from the carbonyl group side chain, that is C terminus, and to the amino group side N terminus of the amino acid chain. Now, why we need to synthesize the peptide chains through solid phase synthesis? in order to have so many applications of synthetic peptides, we need to synthesize the peptide chains through the solid phase synthesis, which could be immune peptides, synthetic antigens, vaccines, diagnostic tools, immunostimulator peptides, muramyl dipeptide, tufsin derivatives, transporter peptides, pentratin oligoarginine, HIV TET protein, peptides for structural studies, turn mimicking cyclic peptides, hormones, oxytocin, vasopressin, insulin, somatostatin, etc. Synthetic peptides can also be used as carriers to deliver diagnostic or therapeutic agents to target cells. While the synthetic peptides prepared through the solid phase synthesis can also be applied or can also be used as neuropeptides, cholestokinin, neurotensin, these are used as antibiotics, tachykinin, gramicidine S, while these are also used as toxins, conotoxins, spider toxins, snake toxins, and ion channel blockers. While these are also applied as enzymes and enzyme inhibitors, for example, ribonuclease A. If we compare the peptide synthesis with in solution phase and in solid phase synthesis, what is the difference between the synthesis of peptides in regular organic synthesis or solution phase synthesis and solid phase synthesis? In solution synthesis, the reaction conditions have to be optimized, and to improve the yield, we have to perform the reaction again and again in order to optimize the reaction conditions. While during regular organic synthesis of the peptides, there are various steps of purification are involved, as at each step we need to purify our product in order to move towards the next step. So due to this solution phase synthesis is very time consuming, and it can be applied for the synthesis of small peptide molecules. It is not useful, or it could be less useful for the large scale manufacturing of the large peptide molecules. While if we talk about the solid phase synthesis involves the anchoring of peptide chain on a resin. A resin is any polymeric material on which the first monomer molecule or amino acid is anchored, is attached on it, and this synthesis does not involve the purification at each and every step. It involves the use of excess reagents removed by filtration and washing procedures. It is simple, rapid, and repetitive steps. Through this solid phase synthesis, we obtain the high yields of the peptide chains along with possible automation. This method is applied with very successfully for the synthesis of long peptide chains, RNA and DNA molecules for the synthetic purposes of the these oligomeric molecules. Solid phase peptide synthesis. The principal features of Merrifield technique involved the use of a polymeric material that was prepared by mixing 2 para divinyl benzene, 5 para chloromethyl styrene, 93% styrene, and it became a porous gel seed like polymer, as this is shown through CH2Cl polymer. Actually, solid phase synthesis is a common technique for peptide synthesis. This technique was represented by Merrifield in 1964 for the synthesis of the peptide molecules. He prepared this through the protection of the amino group in the first step. Then this amino acid was reacted with the polymeric material that was this porous seed, gel like seed. He attached the first amino acid on this porous polymeric resin, and after the reaction with the polymer, the second amino acid reacted with the first protected NH2 amino acid. After the completion of the reaction, he deprotected that amino acid and followed by the removal of the polymeric resin. So usually the peptides are synthesized from the carbonyl group side C terminus to the amino group side N terminus of the amino acid chain in this method. Although peptides are biologically synthesized in the opposite direction in the cells, in peptide synthesis, an amino-protected amino acid is bound to a solid phase material, most commonly low cross-linked polystyrene beads, forming a covalent bond between the carbonyl group and the resin, most often an amido or an ester bond. Then the amino group is deprotected and reacted with the carbonyl group of the next amino protected amino acid. The solid phase now bears a dipeptide. This cycle is repeated to form the desired peptide chain. After all the reactions are completed, the synthesized peptide is cleaved from the bead. Synthesis protocol. Solid phase synthesis typically involves the use of a resin, a non-soluble polymer-based material which is pre-functionalized so the starting building block can easily bind. First of all, we use the resins which swells in the reaction solvent, and the second step is the protection of the amino group of the first amino acid. So the building blocks are generally protected once they are added onto the resin, and they can easily be deprotected and treated with the next desired building block in the solution. Once the desired molecule has been synthesized, it can easily be cleaved from the raisin. Now I was talking about the cell use of raisin, and in the second step, which involves the protection of the amino group, and we can use different protecting groups like FMOC or BOC. So the first FMOC protected amino acid attachment with the polymer. This first protected amino acid will react with the second amino acid for the coupling reaction. After the completion, this protecting group is washed with dimethyl formamide, and when the desired molecule is synthesized, the protecting group can be removed or it can be deprotected, and leading to the next step, which involves the reaction of third amino acid with this chain, and leading to the multi-step synthesis of the this peptide chain. After last coupling, this polymeric raisin is removed or it is washed by the hydrogen fluoride or trifluoroacetic acid. SPSS can easily take the advantage of FMOC and BOC and protecting groups on the amino acids to build up the libraries of peptides in a short amount of time. FMOC strategy in peptide synthesis. I am discussing again and again about the protection of the amino group. Which type of functional groups, protecting groups are used for the protection of the amino group? One of the protecting group is the application of the FMOC. FMOC is the fluorinyl methyl oxycarbonyl protecting group. This molecule is used as protecting group. Actually, the FMOC strategy is based on an orthogonal protecting group strategy. Using the base labile FN FMOC protect group for protection of the amino group, and acid labile side chain protecting groups and resin linkage agents. Here, if we talk about the process or the mechanism of the reaction which takes place, the carbon terminal of the amino acid residue of the target peptide is attached to an insoluble support via its carboxyl group. As you can see, the first step, the NH of the amino acid is attached with the FMOC protecting group, while the C terminal is attached with a polymeric resin. This polymeric resin it will protect the carboxylic acid group. Any functional groups in the amino acid side chains must be masked with a permanent protecting group that are not affected by the reaction conditions employed during peptide chain assembly. The temporary protecting group masking the alpha amino group during the initial resin loading is removed. An excess of second amino acid is introduced with the carboxyl group of this amino acid being activated for amide bond formation through generation of an activated ester or by reaction with a coupling reagent. After coupling, excess reagents are removed by washing and protecting group removed from the N-terminus of the dipeptide prior to the addition of third amino acid residue. Now you can see in this reaction scheme that the first amino acid is protected through the amino group is protected through the MOC, and the other carboxyl group is at the O position is protected through the polymer. And when the second amino acid is need to be attached, the FMOC is removed and coupling take place. With the carboxylic acid that is activated, it will react with the second amino acid. After the repeated reaction, the deprotection and coupling, when we obtain the long chain of the amino acid, the protecting group is removed through the cleavage. FMOC deprotection. The process of peptide synthesis is repeated until the desired peptide chain is obtained. As the side chain protecting groups and resonance linkages are chosen such that protecting groups are removed and the assembled peptide released under the same conditions. This in practice, the tertiary butyl and trityl based side chain protection and alkoxy benzyl based linkers are used, as they can be removed by TFA. This reagent is an excellent solvent for the peptides and can be used in the standard glass laboratory glassware, and being volatile is readily removed by evaporation. Indeed, it is this convenience of the cleavage reaction and the ease with which the method can be adapted to multiple peptide synthesis. The temporary NFMOC protecting group is removed with 20% piperidine in DMF. Coupling is typically carried out in DMF or NMP with preformed active esters or using activation reagents that generate in situ benzo triazolyl esters. Cleavage of the peptide from the resin and global side chain deprotection is effected with 95% TFA. The background and development of FMOC approach is very simple and informative. BOP strategy in peptide synthesis. If we use another protecting group for the peptide synthesis, that is tertiary butoxy carbonyl group. Actually, by using the BOC strategy, the carbon terminal amino acid is anchored to the support through the formation of a benzyl ester with hydroxy methyl phenyl acetyl amido methyl polystyrene. Actually, this is the name of the polymeric resin which is get attached to the carboxylic end or the C terminal of the first amino acid in order to start the peptide chain synthesis. The original support chloromethyl polystyrene is rarely used now. The tertiary butoxy carbonyl or BOC group is used for the temporary protection of the alpha amino group. Removal of this group is usually effected with neat trifluoroacetic acid or TFA in dichloromethane. As you can see in this whole reaction, again just like the FMOC strategy, the polymeric resin is attached with the C terminal forming the ester, while the Bok protecting group protects the first NH2 group. After deprotection of the NH2, this NH2 will react with another amino acid, second amino acid, through the C terminal and forming an amide linkage of the peptide chain, which will lead to the coupling of this amide group with another third amino acid to form the long peptide chain. And after cleavage of the polymeric resin and the Bok material or the Bok protecting group, we will obtain the peptide and polymer. Coupling of Bok was originally carried out by the activation of the incoming amino acid with dicyclohexyl carbodiamide in DCM. For masking of the side chains of trifunctional amino acids, a range of benzyl-based protecting groups have been developed, chemically fine-tuned to suit the requirements of particular functional groups by substitution of the benzyl ring with appropriate electron donating or electron withdrawing groups. Actually, the release of the peptide from the resin and the removal of the side chain protecting group is usually affected with anhydrous hydrogen fluoride. The final step for the peptide chain synthesis is the isolation and purification of the peptide chain. The precipitated by addition of cold diethyl ether, the peptide chain is precipitated by using the diethyl ether, while the Bok or FMOC protecting groups can be released from the side peptide chain with 20% piperidine in DMF, and this is also affected through the trifluoroacetic acid. Because the release of the peptide from the resin and the removal of the side chain protecting groups is usually affected with anhydrous hydrogen fluoride or trifluoroacetic acid. Then the peptide chain is centrifuged and washed with diethyl ether 3 times. As I have already told you that the washing and the separation of the peptide chain leads to obtain the final product. This peptide chain is dried in the vacuum after purification with the HPLC or other techniques. This will lead towards the characterization of this peptide chain. Students, you are required to study about the solid phase synthesis of DNA and RNA, so that you can be very clear about this topic. If you find any question about this topic, feel free to ask me through the email or through the WhatsApp, etc.
थैंक यू, अल्लाह हाफिज़।